Another great East End tradition, and I'm glad to say it still is boxing. Now, when the kids round here couldn't afford the local entertainment or they were too young to go in the pubs, they'd come here. It was every boy's dream to become world champion, bring honour to his patch and maybe a few quid to his pocket. At the Broad Street Club down in Shadwell, potential champions do their workouts under the critical eye of their trainer, Johnny Gleed.
Moving the wrong way. Jab it out.
Why do you think that boxing's so always been so popular in the East End?
Well, I think mainly because you had the docks, you had the markets, everyone come to the markets, the porters, and it was just a tradition that they want their boys to take up.
What sort of kids you get down here?
Well, you get a mixture. You get all ages, you get the hounds, you get the good ones, you get the bad ones, but virtually they're all good. Because when they take up boxing, they become good.
Yourself, can you spot a potential champion?
Not right from the off. I mean, you can get a boy come up, you think, oh, it's a waste of time. Give him about 3 or 4 months and you look and you say, where's he come from? And you've got a good boy. They've got to be disciplined. And this is one of the finest games. But the National Service for disciplining boys, because you can always put them in with someone better. And they know this. Well, not only that, it gives them, it learns boys respect, a lot of respect.
Boxing has always provided entertainment in the East End, just as the old music halls once did. One such place, of course, is the Hackney Empire, where I sat in the gods when I was a kid. There's no one who knows more about the history of music hall than my old mate, Roy Hudd.
I suppose about the end of the 1800s, there must have been 50 or 60 huge music halls in the East End of London. I mean, there was one called the Foresters in Commercial Road, which seated, believe it or not, 3,000 people. It was a baptism of fire, you know, to play musicals in those days, because they had a thing in musicals in those days called a trial turn matinee. And the story actually comes from the Foresters in Cambridge Road, that there's a lady singer, and of course the East Enders loved these trial matinees, didn't they? They could really have a go at the performance. And the lady singer comes on, you know, and she's halfway through her song, and the audience are going mad, shouting, chucking things and all that, and a bloke stood up at the front, and he said, all right, give the poor cow a chance. And she stopped and looked down at him, and she said, thank God there's one gentleman in the audience. Lovely stuff, isn't it?
Well, not many people realise it, but Chaplin started on the East End stage.
Yeah, at a theatre called the Cambridge Music Hall in the Commercial Road, and he started. It was his very first stage appearance. I mean, every theatre you go to in England, to say, Charlie Chaplin appeared here, you know. And, of course, he did. He went on tour with a play about Sherlock Holmes and played the page boy in it. But that was his very first appearance, was at the Cambridge and Commercial Road. And that was an interesting theatre because it was built in the 1860s, and that had a facelift in 1890. And you talk about value for money in those days. It'd been about sixpence or a shilling to get in. When they had a facelift in the 1890s, there were 49 turns on the bill. 49 turns.
Well, what sort of money could they earn then?
Not a lot, I wouldn't think, would you? I mean, although George Laybourne, of course, was earning £140 a week in the 1860s. £140 a week, which is like 2 years' money for the average bloke. So they did earn a lot of money. The big stars did.
Stories like that, you know, are just as much a part of the East End as jellied eels, knees-ups, street markets, and, of course, Cockney rhyming slang. That'll never change.